types of lines. Parallel lines. So we have two lines here, AB line and CD line. So between them we have two vertical bars. They are parallel lines. When two lines are parallel, they never meet. So always the same distance apart and never touching to each other. So we are calling them parallel lines. Here AB line is parallel to CD line and they never meet. Let me write it here. Parallel lines never meet or they don't intersect. So AB line intersection CD line will be empty set. So they don't intersect. We are calling them parallel lines. So that's one of the postulates in geometry. Parallel lines don't intersect. But is it true? What do you think? Today we have other types of geometries. Now, currently, we are learning plane geometry or Euclidean geometry. We are calling this Euclidean because of what? Because the Greek mathematician Euclid, I think 2,300 years ago, he wrote a book, 13 books, Elements of Geometry. He gave us the fundamental concepts, figures in the geometry. Today, we are using them. And because of that, we are calling this geometry plane geometry or Euclidean geometry. Why we are calling this plane geometry? Because all of our figures will be on the plane. So we will have a flat surface. There won't be 3D, just 2D, two-dimensional figures. So we are calling them plane geometry. But if you have spherical geometry or there are some other geometry types, parallel lines, they may intersect. In fact, there are no parallel lines there. Let me give you the example. Look at this. This is our Earth, equator level. All the lines are parallel to each other. But if you look at the North Pole and the South Pole, they intersect. So here, all of them intersect at the same point. But in fact, they are parallel. But the problem is our Earth, it's not a flat surface, spherical shape. If we have a spherical shape like that, so there are 90 degrees, and this is a triangle, I am drawing a triangle, and this angle may be 90 degrees. Normally, some of the interior angles of a triangle is 180, but here 270. What is the problem? Because our figure on a spherical shape, it's not a flat surface, it's not a plane geometry. So we have a different geometry. Another example. So this is the A road from Dubai to Sarajevo. Look at it. The distance between two points, our first point is A, second point is B. As you know, the shortest distance between two points is a straight line, is it? It should be a straight line. That's the shortest distance. If you want to go from A to B, the shortest road should be this one. But why we have this blue road? Why the planes, they have this road? Why? What's the problem here? So this is a straight line, this one. It is a straight line. Okay, who will tell me the reason? Why?
Because the earth is round.
Thank you very much, Abe. We have a spherical shape. It's not a flat surface. In fact, all maps are wrong. They are not correct. Because our earth has a spherical shape. You cannot open it. It cannot be a flat surface. It's not possible. Just imagine you have a balloon and you are trying to make it flat surface, like a rectangular shape. It's not possible. It's impossible. But we need to represent it. Because of that, we have some methods to draw the maps. This is one of them. So the blue line is shorter than that red line. But here on the flat surface, it's a plane. Of course, the red line is shorter than that blue curve. It's a curve. It's not a plane. It's not a straight line. But if you have a spherical shape, it will be a straight line as well. And it will be shorter than that one because it's not possible. The red line is not possible because we have a spherical shape. Okay, this was extra information for you. But in the plane geometry, parallel lines, they don't intersect. They never meet. That's it. cases of. Second possibility and types of like intersecting lines. If two lines are not parallel to each other, they will meet somewhere. They will intersect. So here our intersection point is point A. They are not parallel, they will intersect. So in English, I can explain this in this way. So that's the point A. We are calling that point A point of intersection. So this is called point of intersection. And line L, intersection line M, is point A. So we have only one intersection point. A, we may write this A, is the intersection point of line M and line L. I can write in this way. Or line L and line M intersect at point A. So we are calling them intersecting lines because they intersect at one point, and A is the intersection point here. I have one question for you. Is it possible to have two intersection points? We have two lines. They are not parallel to each other.
Yes.
If you have two intersection points, what will happen?
That means they are the same line.
Naila, wonderful. What did you say, Naila? Can you repeat it again?
That means they are the same line.
Yes, you are right. Why? Remember our first postulate. Two points determine a line. If you have two points, you could draw only one straight line, which is passing through both of them. If you have two intersection points, they need to be same line. But we have a special name for them. We are calling them coincident lines. Two lines that line on top of one another are called coincident lines. We have two lines, L and M. If they intersect at point A and B, so line L and line M, they will be the same line. All of the points will be common. I mean, if you have two intersection points, it means there will be infinitely many intersection points because they will be the same line. Now the fourth one. Fourth one is, in fact, it's not a special case, intersecting lines. I mean, it's the special case for the intersecting line. If two lines intersect at 90 degrees, we are calling them perpendicular lines. Their intersection point is here, 90 degrees. So lines that form right angles at their intersection are perpendicular. Or if two lines intersect at 90 degrees, then they are called perpendicular line. So here, PQ line is perpendicular to RS line. Look at this notation. For the parallel lines, we were using two vertical bars. For the perpendicular lines, we are using this notation. So they are perpendicular to each other. This one means perpendicular. So let's take a look at this figure. Look at this. Here we have three lines. AB line. Second line is CD line, and the third one is DE line. We have three lines. Now, please tell me the parallel lines here, perpendicular lines. Who will tell me the parallel lines here? Aydın, are you there, Aydın?
Yes.
Could you tell us the parallel lines in this figure, Aydın? Just tell me, I will write it.
We have the parallel lines AB and CD.
Wait a minute. AB line? You mean AB line is parallel to CD line? Are you sure, Aydın?
No, DE. DE, I meant DE.
Yes. Parallel lines, they don't intersect. So DE line, the second line should be DE. They are parallel to each other because they don't intersect. They never meet. Okay, so we have one more pair for the
it is DE.
Yes. DE and what? DE line is perpendicular to which line, Emina?
CD.
Yes, CD. Thank you very much. So here, AB line is perpendicular to CD and DE line is perpendicular to CD. They are perpendicular. Why? Because they intersect at 90 degrees. So we are calling them perpendicular. I think it's clear now, this part, perpendicular lines. They are intersecting lines, but they intersect at 90 degrees. Then we have another term, concurrent lines. Concurrent lines. So concurrent lines, look at the figure, you will understand the meaning. So three or more lines, they are intersecting lines, by the way. Three or more lines passing through the same point are called concurrent. They are concurrent lines. Why? Because they intersect at one point, point P. We are calling them concurrent lines. If they intersect at one point, you may have this case. They are not concurrent lines. Let me draw some other lines. This is the first one, then the second one. Then here we have third one. So here we have three lines. They are intersecting lines as well, but they are not concurrent lines. Why? Look at the intersection points. Here we have one, here we have two, here we have three. We have three different intersection points. So they are not concurrent. But if we have only one, they are concurrent lines. In fact, there is no other possibility in the Euclidean geometry and the plane geometry. So you may not have any other type. But in the space, we have one more type. We are calling them skew lines. So skew lines are two lines not in the same plane that do not intersect. So they are not in the same plane and they don't intersect to each other. So if you look at this figure, in fact, it seems something like the intersection point here, but in fact, there is no intersection point there. Just imagine this is 3D. One of the lines is, this is, let's say, line L. It's in the plane P. This is a plane P. And there's another line M, which is perpendicular to plane P. And line L and line M, they don't intersect. They are not parallel to each other, then we are calling them skew lines. Can you imagine this figure in 3D? It's very difficult to draw a 3D figure in 2D because we are using a flat surface, not 2D. But these two lines are in 3D. But I think you will understand now. Look at this. I have a cube here. So let me draw some lines here. I will draw a line here, this line, and I have the first line here, so I will call it line L. This is our first line. So there's another line. Let me draw this one here. This is our second line. Here it is. And I will call this line M. Okay. There will be another line. Look at this. This line. And I will call this line L, M, and N. Let's say this is line N. Okay, so we have three lines here, L, M, and N. What can you say about line L and line M? So L and M are intersecting lines, and they are in the same plane, this plane, plane P. They are in the same plane. They are intersecting lines. In fact, they are perpendicular lines. I can write this. Line L is perpendicular to line M. Why? Because this angle is 90 degrees, because this is a cube. This is 90 degrees. So they are perpendicular to each other, line L and line M. What about line L and line M? Not M now. What can you say about L and N, okay? They are in the same plane as well. Which plane? Let me call that plane is plane R, okay? This is plane R. So they are in the same plane. So what can I say about line L and N? Are they intersecting lines? Okay, tell me, Faruk.
They are parallel.
Parallel, yes. Line L is parallel to line N. Okay, L and M. Intersecting lines, perpendicular lines, because they intersect at 90. Line L and line N are parallel to each other. Now, the strange case. What about line M and line and M and N. It's in 3D. They are not intersecting, as you can see. They don't intersect. M and N. Are they parallel? M and N?
No.
M and N, they are not parallel, Hamza. So for that kind of lines, we have a special name. They are not in the same plane. Look at this. Line M in plane P. Line N in plane R. They don't intersect. They are not parallel. So we are calling them. What was the name of that kind of line? We are calling them skew lines. So they are skew lines. I think now you understood the meaning of the skew lines. Skew lines are two lines not in the same plane and that do not intersect. They are not in the same plane. It's in 3D, so we cannot have skew lines in the plane geometry. You cannot draw two skew lines in the plane. It's not possible. If two lines in the plane, they may be parallel, they may intersect, or they may be the same line. There is no other possibility in the plane. But in the space, we have the fourth case. We are calling that case skew lines. They are not parallel and they don't intersect.